Shalom, Brother Stephanie. So let we continue. Now let us go to Isaiah 53. This quickly, like, kind of, you know, we got to go with the Spirit. So let us go on forth. 53, verse 1. Who hath believed our report? Our report. This is, you know, this is, we're writing out this report. We got to report on such issues and be like, yep, Christ in his kingly character. That's God right there. And his Christ, Ethiopian Yeshua. And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? Yeah, so okay, let us return forward to the book of Romans, because we could, I mean, that whole chapter is this whole book is on his majesty and his Christ, and so is but let us stick to the game plan. Because if not, we will be here in eternity and then some. So let us continue. Because that, and this is the Epistle of Paul the Apostles to the Romans, chapter 1, and we're on verse 21. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. You know, that has to do with Kaiser Borgia, vain in their imagination. It's like, nah, his majesty's not God. It's like, nah, you know, you learn how to tell it in people when you say something, and it's like they put this look and they store it in their subconscious, and then they honestly don't remember it, and I can testify to this. I've said things, and I see the look, and I'm all like, oh yeah, they're ignoring this. Their mind is saying there's an alarm going on and being like, dee, 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 you know, do not pay attention. And, you know, it's like an elevator music turns on, and then the subconscious is, you know, takes over. It kind of like smacks the frontal lobe and kind of like tells them that he's got no authority dealing with this subject matter. And so it's stored in the subconscious or something, or done away with. And then the next day, I hear the same person saying exactly what I said and speaking, like, in ignorance, and honestly, not having any clue whatsoever that I said exactly that what they are saying now, you know. And it's funny. And it has to do with Willie Lynch, what I said, right? And so the next day, they're saying something that I exactly had mentioned. As evidence to how Willie Lynch is practically what formed our family, as this fleshy family. So nonetheless, that's off topic. Let us continue. And so because, verse 21 once more, because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. Because the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There's much to review, you know, concerning that, but let us seek to do that in a more complete presentation focused on the darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools and changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to corruptible man. That's that Kaiser Borgia. And to birds and four-footed beasts and creeping things. Now, this doesn't mean that man made an image of God, of animals and stuff like that, although in some cases they have, but nonetheless, this is because, listen, we have to clarify this because we do not want to allow any breathing space for the wicked to creep in and do what they do and deceive. No, we can't give them even the smallest opportunity. The reason it's explicating in such a way is because it's making mention, it's setting the authority of God the Father, you know, in the authority, you know, the power of God the Father in the authority of the Son, Jesus Christus, and stating and establishing and making firm, you know, firmly grounding that I am the creator and you are the created. Just like I created man, I created beast. And so it's not to say that this this verse does not apply to Kaiser or Borgia. It does. What it's entailing and making known is that I am the creator of all. So I created man and I created beast. You are the created. And so let us go on to verse 24. Wherefore God also gave them up to uncleanness through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of God into a lie, and worshipped and served the creature. You see, that's what it's referring to, man and beast, more than the Creator, who is blessed forever and ever and ever and ever. Amen and amen. But gave them up to uncleanness through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies. Yeah, we Rastafari do not understand that, so we don't know. We don't get into that. But we will mention that the heart was darkened. They go back to Moses. They go back to putting a veil. They don't want to deal with God. They'll be like, nah. We'll set up a three-party contractual agreement. Whatever he says, we'll do. And then once that's established, one man thinks that he's the one to set boundaries. You know, Jah wanted I and I to be a peculiar people, but the people automatically set up boundaries. It's like, whatever he says, we'll do. And so they exposed themselves to law. And now, you know, Jah's like, all right, you guys want to set boundaries? I'll say how far you can go. And now, Jah Almighty comes down and people get all panicked and stuff. And Moses comes to them and lets them know, like, don't fear, you know, it's like, this is our redemption. And the people is all like, nah, we don't want to speak to the Almighty. We don't want to hear him, as a matter of fact, you know, cancel whatever we said. So they break another covenant. They break the covenant once more. And they're like, whatever he tells you, we'll do what you say. We don't want to go through him. And so they go back to that veil, not that covering, that darkness. They want to stay in a shadow, in a darkened, they want to keep to their imagination, to imagine that which they their dark heart, ignorant of all divinity, they want to keep to that imagination where their darkness of all ignorance of divinity, their darkness in all ignorance of all divinity, of the Almighty Creator and His Son, right? They want to keep to that imagination where they can make it be whatever they want it to be. And so they can pretend and pretend and pretend and not have to respond to truth. That's why it says here that so that they are without any excuse, without excuse. You see? Because let us mention that, you know, the rabbinic teachings and people, those rabbis that supposedly study, interpret Bible, you quickly find out that they're in a whole mess of technicalities. And so they do that because that way they could do whatever they want. As long as they're sticking to they're keeping to the veil, to the shadows of old things, now seen in the revelation and in the light of His Majesty, you know, Christ in His kingly character. Those technicalities that they keep to makes them, whether it be exalt themselves or just keeps them in vain imaginations. You see, like it gives them the opportunity because God was not seen for them to make God whatever they wish for God to be. One example, I pray that and I hope that this isn't confusing any, but If you accept Christ in His kingly character, that means that you have to walk the walk because you've seen it and you've seen man do it. And the fact that, you know, the Sadducees and Pharisees, they said, you know, you Jesus of Nazareth or something, you Jesus being man, make yourself God. They hated the fact, they hated His humanity, not only His color, not only His skin, but in fact, it could have been that many of the other side were African, of African skin, of black skin. And so it wasn't only that. It was like, nah, that means that if we accept that you're God, we gotta get our act together. We gotta change. And because you're a man and you drink, you eat, you breathe, you cry, you laugh, and you bleed, you know, we can touch you, we can see you, you're there. That means that we're gonna have to get our act together, and we're gonna have to do what you say, what you do. We're gonna have to follow in that example. And so that is life to I and I, and that is death to them. That's the valley of the shadow of death to them, because now they're in a valley of judgment, of the valley of Yehoshaphat, if I'm not mistaken in pronunciation, but the self-judgment, you know. And that is life to I and I, Rastafari, Jesus Christos. You know, His Majesty made mention, you know, that every man must do his best to emulate, to duplicate, to represent, to make manifest, to achieve, to attain, to walk as closely as possible to the good example that Jesus Christos has set for us. You know? And here's where the technicality of the rabbinic teachers comes into play. Men, oh, that means that, you know, that means that older men don't apply to this. That means that men that are younger don't apply to this. Women and children do not apply. If you're sick, then you don't have to do the commandments, and you don't have to walk the way in Jesus Christos. If you're deaf, if you're blind, if you're, see, this is all the excuses they put up, because they'll go into legalities and technicalities and hypocrisy, and be like, oh no, men doesn't mean old men, and I'm already 40, so that doesn't apply to me. And so that's kind of like the game that they like to play, imaginary. And so they refuse to accept that God was made manifest in man, revealing and making shown His glory forever and ever. Amen and amen. You know, we give thanks and praises God the Father, first power of the Trinity, in the authority of Geta Jesus Christos. Now, continuing. Verse 25. Who changed the truth of God into a lie, and worshipped and served the creature more than the Creator, who is blessed forever and ever. Amen and amen. For this cause God gave them up to the vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error which was meet. Darkness is error. It's misery. And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient. Now this is going to go into a description of what we are confronted with, because we'll go into a deeper or more in-depth explanation of that. But listen closely, and look around, and you know, and witness to what we are beholding. Being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of Jah Rastafari in its true Ethiopian humanity, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding, without they don't know what that word even means, much less overstanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable, unmerciful, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them. Therefore, thou art inexcusable, O man, whosoever thou art that judgest. But you know, let us just jump over to let us spring over to chapter 2, verse 4. Or despisest thou the riches of his goodness and forbearance and longsuffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leadeth thee to repentance? You know, repent. That's it. You know, on a personal level, you know, I and I, Rastafari, you know, stretching our arms out to those willing to receive. Repent. You know, and this speaks about homosexuality or, you know, falsely called, whatever it is, you know, wickedness and evil. That's a mistake. And I personally, it's not going to judge the eye. Just repent, you know, that, you know, come to the conclusion that, hey, maybe man and man aren't meant to be. You know, we all make mistakes. So just repent from all your wickedness and evil. That's all. There's forgiveness as an offering by the Almighty through the authority of the Son. And let us go really quick to the book of Isaiah, because this will, you know, it's worthy to give one's the opportunity of repentance. Now, give it just 1 second. Okay, and it's Isaiah chapter 55, and it reads, "Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return to the Lord, Yetah, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are the ways my ways, saith Yetah." You know, so that's just extra comfort for those, you know, just repent, you know, but sincerely, in all truth, repent. So, yeah, let us conclude there as far as Romans. Oh, let us add one more thing. You know, and it's only proper, being that we are in a state of Rome. Well, not us as Rastafari, but okay, and this is an introduction we did to a movie that is called The Lion of Judah War with Ethiopia or something like that. But we titled it, and it's on Rastafari Fellowship. It's like an hour and a half. It's good footage. It's recommended. And it's not in parts. We filmed it so that it's all continuous. So this is the introduction that we did for that movie. And the theme was Star Wars, Return of Yehuda, the Yehudite. Long ago, in a nearby fallacy, far, far from truth, the Vatican, evil in all thought, my thoughts are not the thoughts of man, says Geta, perceived themselves to be white. And in this unenlightened idea of superiority, had no life. You know, the fools thinking themselves to be wise. And the fact that ones think that a color is represents a truth, you know, establishes this false idea of superiority, because that means that another color is inferior. So any idea of thinking that anything or anyone is better results in misery. Now, okay, we have to read that again because we went off track. Long ago, in a nearby fallacy, far, far away, I mean far, far from truth, the Vatican, evil in all thought, perceived themselves to be white, right? And in this unenlightened idea of superiority, had no life. They had no light within them. For they comprehended not the light, because the light shined in darkness. You know, His Majesty and Christ Jesus happens to be black. The true darkness cannot receive and comprehend how light can shine as black skin better. Now, and we have evidence for that, and we'll go into that in our next presentation. Because of this, the Vatican sought to enter and corrupt humanity's interconnection, internet connection, with the inner source, with Igziabhiv, with Amlak, the sustainer. The sustainer Igziabhiv, and Amlak, the source. With the universal, sustaining and supporting force that is good, Yanet, Yahweh, the only way. The Vatican thus led all of humanity to sin. Slaves to sin, humanity was without signal and left disconnected in a state of Rome. And what happens when you're in Rome? You know, no signal, so you can't see the signs. You can't see the signs. You don't know what time it is, and plus you can't receive incoming calls. So let us continue. By way of ignorance and romance, see, this has to do with fascinating and captivating, fascinating. You know, to fasten you, to tie you down, and to captivate, to make you captive with all this ignorance and romance, all within the fallacy played of make-believe or make-be-like-Eve, make you be like Eve in the garden with white light saviors playing with these Kaiser Borgias. When the incoming true light was in the world, his own did not receive his call, because in the state of roaming, light was considered skin, but the light shined in darkness. If not for the true light and the elect few who overstood all and received willingly, all would have been lost. You see, people are waiting for a white Jesus Christ, man. It's like we don't get into that, you know? So give thanks, you know. Check out the next presentation. It has everything to do with this. Shalom Rastafari.